Well, good morning, church family. It is Saturday, May the 9th, and I just want to say I hope that you are having a good day today. This is going to be my last devotional in the Fear Not series, and I just want to say thank you for being a part of this journey. And some days were better than others, that's for sure, but I appreciate you being with us here online, and I hope and pray that through all of this that you're closer to God, and that you understand maybe a little bit more about who He is, and that during these times, hard times, that we have to really lean in and rely on the sovereignty of our Almighty King, and our sovereignty of God, and trust in His Son, our Almighty King. So, but with that, I want to read. Today's devotional comes from John chapter 16, and it's a few verses, so just bear with me, but it's John chapter 16, verses 24 through 33. And I'm going to tell you kind of the last truth, well, not the last truth, but our devotional last truth today, and hopefully you'll be blessed, and that you'll walk closer to Jesus through this. So, John chapter 16, verses 24 through 33, Jesus is talking to His disciples here, and He's actually talking about grief and, becoming joyous, grief turning into joy, different things like that. I'm going to start off at 24, and it says this. It says, remember, this is Jesus talking to His disciples. It says, "Until now, you have not asked for anything in My name. Ask and you will receive, and your joy will be complete. Though I have been speaking figuratively, a time is coming when I do not longer use this kind of language, but will tell you plainly about My Father. In that day, you will ask in My name. I am not saying that I will ask the Father on your behalf. No, the Father Himself loves you because you have loved Me and have believed that I came from God. I came from the Father and entered the world. Now I am leaving the world and going back to the Father." And then Jesus' disciples said, "Now you are speaking clearly and without figures of speech. Now we can see that you know all things, and that you do not even need to have anyone ask you questions." Basically, the disciples are saying, "Oh, we understand now who you are. We get it now." Then they said, "This makes us believe that you came from God." And then Jesus says, "Do you now believe?" Jesus replied, "A time is coming, and in fact has come, when you will be scattered, each to your own home. You will leave Me all alone. Yet I am not alone, for My Father is with Me. I have told you these things so that in Me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world." Jesus Himself says that in this world we are going to have trouble. In this world, we're going to be scared. In this world, we are going to be in pain. In this world, we are going to hurt. In this world, there will be seasons in our life where we just feel like we don't know what's going on. We're scared out of our mind. We're anxious. He says, in this world, you will have trouble. You see, I believe that there's a phrase that says, God will never give us more than we can handle. But I don't believe that's a true statement in the essence of what it is. I think it's a misconception of another verse that says, "You will not be tempted more than we can handle." That's a totally different subject or totally different text. We won't be tempted more than we can handle. But I believe we will go through things in this life that we cannot handle. We'll hurt so bad in this life sometimes that all we have to do is basically lean in and totally trust in, totally believe, totally put all of our faith into God. I believe that that's what happens in this life. Because Jesus said Himself, you will have troubles in this world. But the great thing, now this is, because that's a lot of, that's a devotion was supposed to be helpful and encouraging. But the truth is, Jesus has overcome this earth. Jesus has overcome this world. He has dominion. He will eventually, and I believe now, but he has total, complete dominion over this world. And even though right now we have to go through those some struggles and pain, because he has overcome this world, that we can rely on him during those times. And he can give us our peace. That's why Jesus said, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. And my prayer, guys, is that during any kind of thing, whether it's during this time of the corona crisis, or whether it's time of just other horrible, maybe, you know, bad seasons in your life, where you're hurting, where you're pain, maybe it's a death of a loved one, or maybe it's you know, losing jobs, whatever season that you're going through that you're hurting, that you would have the peace of God, because Jesus has overcome this world, and we can rely on that truth. We can rely on that God is sovereign. And even though we only see a little small glimpse of what's going on in history at the time of what the season we're going through, God knows it all. And my prayer is that during all these things, whether we have they're talking about having something else in the fall, you know, another reoccurring of COVID or something, you know, whatever the next thing is that you're going to go through, my prayer is that you have the peace of God that transcends all understanding, and realize that because of who Jesus is and who God is. And then you can rely on him during those times. Is it hard? Yes. Will you be in pain? Probably. But God gives us the grace and the mercy to make it through those times. And he does that for everybody. So my prayer is that you're following Jesus daily, that you're getting into his word, and that you will be encouraged to know that he will see you through whatever situations are going on in your life. I love you, and just rely and trust in Jesus during those times. Every time, but especially during those times, lean into him more. Let's pray. God, I just want to thank you for this time of being here together with the church family. And Lord, my prayer is that we are totally seeking after you. And God, that we're relying on you. And God, that we know that good times are going to be here, and those are great times, Lord. Let us worship you and praise you during those times. But God, we also know that hard times will come. God, Jesus told us himself that. And Lord, when those hard times come, let us worship and praise you. Let our response be the same. But God, let us lean into you during those times, Lord. And Lord, that you would carry us through. God, that you would carry us during those hard times, during those trials and tribulations. Lord, the Bible says that you have overcome this world, and we look forward to that, and we rejoice for it. We rejoice for that. But God, during this time, as we're living in this world, let us keep our eyes focused on you, God, so that we can have your peace. I love you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Church family, I've thoroughly enjoyed doing this. I hope and pray that you're able to be here next Sunday. If you're not, we're still doing it online. We totally understand that. And I love you. And stay in God's word. Jesus loves you. God loves you. No matter what you're going through, God loves you. You are a child of the King. You have a purpose and a plan, and he has a plan, a purpose for your life. You are a child of the King. And so I just want to encourage you with that today. I love you guys. Stay in the truth of God's word. And in Jesus, there is always hope. God bless.